How to add Fortinet firewall to Evink. First of all, I am opening WinSCP here. We will log in here. Here we are seeing three folders. We will open QEMU. Here we have created a folder named Fortinet FGT V7. I'll open it up and show you. You can see there's nothing here right now. Now we download the Fortinet firewall image, so here we will search for FortiCloud. Here comes the first website, Fortigate Cloud. We'll click on FortiCloud. Here we will click on Login. Here, the email user will be selected. We will enter our email address and password to login. Click on Login as email user. An OTP will be sent to your registered email address and we will post the OTP here. We'll click Go. So this is our dashboard of FortiCloud. Now we will click on Products, Product List. All the devices registered on FortiCloud will be shown here. Now click on Support to download the image, VM Images. Here in Select Product we will select FortiGate. And in Select Platform we will select KVM. Here we are shown two options, latest version and earlier version. So, in the latest version you will find the latest version, and in the earlier version you will find the older version. You can download the latest version if you wish, but for the latest version, you must have a laptop with higher specifications. I'm downloading the older version here. The firewall versions shown here are 7.6.2, 7.4.6, version 7.2.11. I previously tried 7.4.6, but it didn't work properly and kept crashing. I am downloading the version 7.2.11 now. We will click on this. We'll come down a little bit here. Here we'll see new deployment of FortiGate for KVM. We'll click on it. Our image file will begin downloading. Our file has been downloaded. I go to the location. We will extract the file. We need to change the file name. The name will be Versha. So, we'll return to the web browser. Click on Services and click on Asset Management. Click on Products and then Product List. Now, let's add the image to the EVNG. This is the EVNG. Click on Add an Object. Here, we search for Fortinet FortiGate. This image is displayed. We haven't copied our image to the Fortinet folder yet. So, first, we'll copy it there. Open WinSCP. This is our folder, Fortinet FortiGate V7. Let's open it. The file we downloaded is displayed on the left side. We'll select it and simply drag and drop it here. So, we'll paste the image file into the folder. Now, we'll close WinSCP. Once here, let's refresh it. Click on Add an Object. Here, we search for Fortinet FortiGate. Here I'm adding the management cloud. So let's open the Fortinet firewall. Wait a moment while it boots up. This is the firewall's serial number. Here it will ask us for credentials. So the credentials are going to be here. Username, admin. Password, first time password. Nothing happens, so we'll simply press enter. Now we'll create a new password here. We'll confirm the password. This is a mismatch, so I'll change it back. Here, we'll type the command show system interface question mark. This command shows us the IP address. The IP address here is currently set to port 1.192.168.109.129. This IP address is obtained through DHCP. So, we'll access the firewall using this IP address. I'll open it in a new tab. It's not opening. I'll ping its gateway to see if it's accessible. To ping, we'll type the command execute ping, and its gateway will be 192.168.109.2. If the gateway is accessible, it should open. We can see that it's opening. Now, enter the credentials here. Admin. This will be the password we just changed. Now, we need to register our license for the first time. Here, we'll select the evaluation license. Here, we'll enter our FortiCloud credentials. It will register on FortiCloud. Then, it will reboot. Here, we'll click OK. So, it's rebooted. Let me refresh it. Enter your credentials and click on Login. Click on Begin. Save and Continue. Click on the checkbox, OK. OK. Don't show again, OK. So this is the dashboard of our Fortinet firewall. I'll even show you the traffic on this. I'll show you this on a simple setup. Click on Network. Interfaces. Here we find three ports that we can use. I'll set the IP address for port 2. Double-click on it to set the IP address. The port will be for LAN. I'll set it to 10.10.10.1/24. Under services, select HTTPS SSH ping FMG access speed test FTM. Click OK. So, this port is configured for LAN. Now let's add a route. Click on Static Routes. Click on Create New. We're adding a default route, so we'll select Interface Port 1. All our traffic will go to the Internet via Port 1. Click on OK. Now we'll add a policy. Click on Policies and Objects. Firewall Policy. Create New. Name the policy. For now, I'll name it 1.2.LAN. The incoming interface will be port 1. The outgoing interface will be port 2. Source will be all. Destination will be all. Finally, the services will be all. NAT will be enabled. Click on OK. This is our first policy. We will create a policy for LAN 2.1 also. Here, the incoming interface is port 2 and the outgoing interface is port 1. Source will be all. Destination will be all. Here also the services will be all. Click on OK. Now I will also show you here whether the license of this firewall is registered on our FortiLoad or not. Let me refresh it. Here you can see one product is displayed. We'll click on it and open it. If you check here, you'll see the same license number, which will be displayed on your firewall. Now let's return to the topology. Let's add a Windows PC here. So stop the firewall and add the PC here. Let's start both devices. Let's open the PC now. It's showing an error. Let's try it again. No, it's showing an error. Let's wipe it once and it should work. Let's try it once. So it's open now. Let's configure the IP on the PC. Let's try pinging. It's pinging. Let's try opening something on the web. So you can see that PC is getting internet through firewall. So this video was about how you can add Fortinet Firewall to EVing.